Hey, go ahead and give me outlet temperature.
Extreme Power is a high-tech energy company that uses technology originally developed for electric cars to store alternative energy.
The green line that we're following up here, that's the actual output from a wind farm. That's located on the island of Oahu.
The revolutionary process saves energy that's ordinarily wasted. When the company's founders were looking for a place to call home, they chose Austin. Why? The high-tech workforce, connections to the energy sector, and the state's tax structure.
There's a low cost of living, not just for your personnel or staff, but also for the company itself.
Texas attractions include no personal income tax, the second lowest cost of living in the nation, and among the lowest business taxes. That's creating jobs, 129,000 jobs just last year, more than half of all the jobs created in the U.S. And if you hire them, people will come. Over the last decade, Texas's population has grown by more than 20%.
We're really benefiting from a lot of immigration from other high-tax, high-regulation states.
Like California, it's one of the most expensive places to live in the U.S., puts an income tax of more than 10% on its highest earners, and has among the highest corporate income taxes. While Texas added jobs last year, California lost more than 100,000.
If everything's bigger in Texas, including the number of jobs created, Governor Rick Perry says it's because the size of the Lone Star State's government has remained relatively small.
In Texas, we understand that pumping government money out doesn't create jobs. What creates jobs is the private sector.
Your critics will say that while Texas has created a lot of jobs, too many of them are low-wage jobs, and your workforce is less educated than the workforces of other states. Is that a fair criticism? Is that a problem?
The key for me is when you see high-tech companies moving into the state of Texas, and they are. High-tech companies are looking and coming. You got companies like Facebook and PayPal and eBay that are adding jobs to the state of Texas. If they were concerned about the workforce, they wouldn't be coming here.
More than 50 Fortune 500 companies have a presence in Texas. Many are oil companies, a built-in resource that tends to insulate the state's economy. But what's behind the new growth? Many economists credit the way Texas taxes.
As economists, we generally believe that consumption taxes are more efficient than income taxes. And so Texas raises most of its revenue through two forms, either the property tax or the consumption, a sales tax.
Laura Murillo runs the Houston Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, the largest Hispanic chamber in the U.S. When the national economy started to tank, she says Texas became a business destination.
Traditionally, they'd gone to Los Angeles or Miami, and Houston was third on their list of places to go to invest national or corporate dollars. But then that model changed because L.A. and Miami were both having serious economic issues, and suddenly Houston appeared as the place to go.
What are some of the challenges facing particularly your members?
Well, some of the challenges include access to capital. Because of a lot of the regulations that have come about, it is much more challenging, much more difficult for you to obtain loans and lines of credit.
And you're talking about federal regulations?
Federal regulations.
Like all states, Texas faces challenges, an expected future budget shortfall, unfunded pension plans for state and local employees, and a high number of low-wage, uneducated workers. Although its unemployment rate of 8.4% is below the national average, it's still high. And as Governor Perry touts the Texas story on the national stage, he's drawing plenty of critics. It seems silly for Perry to take credit for the state's performance one way or another, writes Annie Lowry for Slate. Economies are complicated. Trends take years and even decades to come into effect. Governors are not omnipotent. Perry is the longest-serving governor in Texas history, and whether you think he's helped the state's economy or not, he's not going to stop making the point that Texas is wide open for business. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, Texas.